Yes. Now we'll discuss about the female genital system, part 1. In this part, we'll discuss about the anatomy of the ovary. First of all, we'll make a diagram. Here is this is uterus, this is cervix, this part is cervix, this is uterine cavity, this is fallopian tube, this is fallopian tube, and here is fimbria. Here is position of ovary, this is ovary. This is pelvic wall. This is McEnroe ligament. This is McEnroe ligament. And here is levator ani. This is levator ani. This is McEnroe ligament. It gives support. And here, fold of peritoneum forms broad ligament. Here is broad ligament. So this is fallopian tube. This is fallopian tube. Here is fold of the peritoneum form the broad ligament. This is ovary. This is uterus. This is McEnroe ligament. This is levator ani. So this is anterior view. If you cut a section from this side, then you will find here is position of urinary bladder. This is anterior structure. This is uterine cavity. This is uterus. And on posterior side, this is rectum. Here is fold of the peritoneum. This covers the uterus on both sides. And this is broad ligament. This ligament is broad ligament, and here is position of mesovarian. This is ovary. Here is ovary. This is ovary. And here is ovarian fossa. This is ovarian fossa. This is ovarian fossa. This is rectouterine pouch of Douglas. Here is this is vesicouterine pouch. This is vesicouterine pouch. So here you can see here one structure line. This is obliterated umbilical artery. Here is position of this is position of the ureter. This is ureter. This is obliterated umbilical artery. These are internal iliac artery and internal iliac vein. See, internal iliac artery and vein. This fossa is ovarian fossa. So first of all, we'll discuss about the ovary. This is ovary. Here, this is ovary. This is lateral pelvic wall. If you make a diagram, this is pubic symphysis. This is arcuate line. Here is position of common iliac artery. It divides into internal iliac and this is external iliac. This is common iliac. This is external iliac. This is internal iliac. And it accompanies with the vein. This is internal iliac. This is external iliac vein. And here is its branch. This is obliterated umbilical artery. This is obliterated umbilical artery here. And here is obturator artery. And obturator vein. This is obturator vein. And very important structure here. This is ureter. This is ureter which cross this structure and goes into the pelvic cavity. This is vertical part and this is oblique part. And here is position of unibladder. This is unibladder. So this is ureter. This is ureter. Here this side, this is ovarian fossa. This is ovarian fossa. Here, ovary lies on the lateral wall. So, if you see the boundary of the ovarian fossa, it is anteriorly bounded by, this fossa is anteriorly bounded by obliterated umbilical artery. Here is external iliac artery and vein. This structure lies anteriorly. And the structure lies posteriorly. Here is, you can see this is ureter and these are internal iliac artery and vein. And the structure which lies on lateral side, these two structures and one nerve lies here. This is obturator nerve. This is obturator nerve. These structures covered by peritoneum. And here in this fossa, ovary lies. Ovary situated here, in case of the enlargement of the ovary or inflammation of the ovary, if these nerve or these structures are compressed, here is obturator nerve, this nerve is compressed. Due to compression of this nerve, patient feel pain on upper medial side of thigh, because this gives supply to the upper medial side of the thigh, and also sometimes pain in the knee joint. Because it gives supply to the obturator nerve, also gives supply to the knee joint. So, this is position of the ovary. If you enlarge ovary, the obturator nerve is compressed here. So, these are relations. This is anterior lesion, this is posterior lesion, and obturator nerve and vessels lies on lateral side. These are lateral lesion. If you make here, this is obturator nerve, here is obturator artery, and obturator vein. So these structures from lateral, lie lateral side and this lies anteriorly, this posteriorly. Here is anterior structure, posterior structure and these structures are lateral, these three structures. Ovary is situated here. its shape is almond shaped, and its dimension is about 3 × 1.5 × 1 cm. An external feature, if you see the color before puberty, its color is pinkish gray, and after puberty gradually it become gray and its surface become rough. Before puberty surface is smooth, after puberty surface become rough due to continuous ovulation and cicatrization. So this is the dimension and shape and color of the ovary. Now external feature of the ovary. External feature, it has two ends. If you see, this is upper end, this is lower end. Upper end lies near the tube. This is known as tubal end. This lower end is near to the uterus. That's why it is known as uterine end. It has two end, upper and lower. Upper is known as tubal, lower is known as uterine end. It has two surfaces. It has medial surface and lateral surface. Here you can see this is medial surface and this is lateral surface. Medial surface is related with here. Here a bursa is present. This is known as bursa ovarica. This area between this here mesosalpinx and this ovary. This part, this is known as bursa ovarica. This is known as bursa ovarica. This is bursa ovarica. And lateral side is related with peritoneum, and lateral to peritoneum there is obturator nerve, obturator artery and vein. So the structures are related lateral side, and this fossa is known as ovarian fossa. So this is lateral lesion. And anterior lesion, anteriorly, here this is obturator umbilical artery, external iliac artery and vein, and posteriorly this is ureter, and this internal iliac artery and internal iliac vein. So it has two ends and two surfaces. You have seen these surfaces, medial and lateral surface, and it has two borders. Here is anterior border, this is anterior border. Here this border is anterior border, this border is posterior border. This anterior border here, you can see here nervous structures, nerve and vessel goes through this border. That's why this border is known as a hilum of the ovary. This border is from the hilum of the ovary. This is hilum, because artery and veins passes through this border. This is hilum. And posterior border is free. And that thing. Here, this is anterior border related to these structures, posterior border related to these structures. This is posterior border related with the ureter, and anterior border related to obturator umbilical artery. Here is this border related with obturator umbilical artery, and this posterior border related with the ureter. Here is ureter. Now peritoneal lesion. Its lesion, peritoneal lesion is covered by peritoneum. Here you can see this is mesovarium through which it is suspended on posterior side. This is posterior layer of the broad ligament. This is posterior layer, and from here peritoneum is reflected and covers the ovary. This is site of the reflection here. a white line is formed at the site of reflection. This is transitional zone. Here, every place in the broad ligament, lining epithelium of the peritoneum is simple squamous epithelium. But here, this epithelium modified and formed simple cuboidal epithelium or germinal epithelium. So this point, this is junction. This point is junction between the squamous epithelium and cuboidal epithelium of the ovary. And here a white line is formed. This white line is known as, at this junction, the white line is formed. This line is known as line of Fure, F-U-R-R-E, line of the Fure, here. So here you have seen the peritoneal relation. And visceral relation already discussed with the surface and border. And one other thing, here is its upper end. This upper end is connected with, this upper end is connected with the infundibulo pelvic ligament. This ligament is infundibulo pelvic ligament. So this ligament, the infundibulum of the uterine tube and ovary, these two structures are attached with the wall of the pelvis. This is infundibulo pelvic ligament, through which uterine artery passes. This is ovarian artery passes. This is a branch of the abdominal aorta. This ovarian artery passes and gives supply to the lateral part of the uterine tube and the ovary. And another structure which attaches to the upper end, this is one fimbri is enlarged here, which is attached with the upper end. This is ovarian fimbri. This is known as ovarian fimbri. This fimbri is known as ovarian fimbri. This is attached with the upper pole. And upper pole is also related with the uterine tube. This is lower pole. This lower end is attached with the ligament, which extends from the lateral angle of the uterus to the lower pole. This is ligament of ovary. This ligament is suspensory ligament of ovary. This is ligament of the ovary. The suspensory ligament of ovary is also known as infundibulopelvic ligament. Infundibulopelvic ligament. And this is ligament of the ovary. This is suspensive ligament, this is ligament of the ovary. Its position, here you can see, in nulliparous, its position is vertical. In multiparous, its position becomes horizontal, like this, in multiparous. And this is upper end goes to lateral side, and medial end goes to medial side. In nulliparous, its position is vertical, like this, and in multiparous, it becomes horizontal. Its axis in nulliparous is vertical, passing like this, and in multiparous, it becomes horizontal. So, these are the relations and features of the ovary. Now its arterial supply. Here you can see, this is ovarian artery, which is a branch of the abdominal aorta. It is abdominal aorta, it gives a branch. This ovarian artery gives supply to the ovary. And another artery, here is position of ureter. This is uterine artery, which crosses the ureter from lateral to medial side upward, and it runs in the fold of the broad ligament and gives supply to the ovary. So ovary is supplied by uterine artery and ovarian artery. Venous delay is same. Here ovarian vein, in the left side this ovarian vein opens into left renal vein. In renal, left renal vein, and on the right side it opens into inferior vena cava directly. Inferior vena cava. So there is a difference between right and left ovarian vein. Here in left side it opens into left renal vein, not inferior vena cava. And in right side this vein opens into inferior vena cava. Lymphatic drainage. Lymphatics follow these artery and vein and drains. Here is pre-aortic and there are para-aortic group of lymph node. So lymphatics goes to pre and para-aortic group of lymph node. One tumor, this is known as Krukenberg tumor, is actually secondary of the carcinoma of the breast and abdominal carcinoma. This tumor passes through transiliomically and reaches into this surface of the surface of the ovary, and Krukenberg tumor is formed. So carcinoma of the breast may extend up to ovary. So its nerve supply is sympathetic nerve from T10 and T11. So this is all about the anatomy of the ovary. Thank you.